the Holy Quran says in Surah Ankabut, chapter 29, verse number 41, that as to those who take for protectors anyone besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they build for themselves houses like that of the spider. And verily, the house of the spider is fragile. It is delicate. Besides the Quran saying that anyone who takes for protectors anyone besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the physical nature of the house will be like that of the spider, fragile, delicate, flimsy. It also gives a reference to the family life, which we have come to know today, that many a times the female spider kills the male spider. The Quran says in Surah An-Naml, chapter 27, verse number 17 and 18, that before Solomon marched the hosts of jinns, men, and birds, and when they reached a lowly valley of ants, one of the ants said, "Get ye into your habitations, lest Solomon and his hosts unknowingly will trample you beneath the feet." People will think, what kind of a fairy tale book is the Holy Quran? This book, the Holy Quran, it's speaking about ants. Ants talking among themselves. It's a fairy tale book. Today we have come to know that any animal or any insect which has the closest resemblance to that of the human being, it is the ant. The ant bury the dead the same way as the human beings do. They have a sophisticated method and division of labor where they have manager, supervisor, workers, etc. They very often meet to chat. They have a sophisticated method of communication. They have marketplaces where they exchange goods. And when they store the grain in winter, and if the grain begins to bud, the ant cut the bud as though they knew that budding will cause rotting of the grain. And in monsoon, if the grain gets wet, they bring it out in the sunlight to dry. Surely you might have seen the ants carrying grains in the sunlight to dry, as though they knew that humidity will cause the development of root system, which will cause rotting of the grain. So Quran speaks about the advanced nature of the ants 1400 years ago. In the field of medicine, the Holy Quran says in Surah Nahl, chapter 16, verse number 60 and 69, that from the belly of the bee, you get a drink of varying colors in which there is healing for mankind. It's recently we have come to know that the honey we have is derived from the bee. It's the bee which is responsible for the honey. We did not know about this before. And today we know honey has got high nutritive values. It's rich in vitamin K and fructose. And it has got mild antiseptic properties. No wonder the Russian soldiers, they used honey to cover up their wounds, which prevented the evaporation of moisture and left very little scar tissue. Any person suffering from an allergy of a particular plant, if honey produced from that plant is given, that person starts developing resistance to that allergy. In the field of physiology, it was Ibn Nafis who 600 years after the revelation of the Holy Quran described the blood circulation. And 1,000 years after the revelation of the Holy Quran, that is 400 years after Ibn Nafis described the blood circulation, William Harvey, he made it famous to the Western world. The food that we eat, it enters the stomach, it enters the intestine. From the intestine, it goes into the blood vessels of the intestine and enters the blood circulation. And the blood circulation takes the food substance to various organs, including the mammary glands, which produce milk. The Quran speaks about the blood circulation and the production of milk in a nutshell in Surah An-Nahl, chapter 16, verse number 66, where it says, that verily in the cattle is a lesson for you. We give you to drink from what is within the bodies, coming from the conjunction of the constituent of the intestine and blood, milk which is pure and pleasant for those who drink. The Quran says in Surah Mu'minun, chapter 23, verse number 21, which is also recited by our Qari, Brother Ashraf Muhammadi, it says that Verily, in the cattle is an instructive sign for you. We give you to drink from what is within the bodies, in which there is various benefits, and of the meat you can eat. Quran describes the blood circulation and the production of milk in a nutshell 1400 years ago. In the field of embryology, there were a group of Arab students who collected all the matter in the Holy Quran dealing with embryology, and they followed the guidance of the Holy Quran in Surah Furqan, chapter 25, verse 59, which says, if you are in doubt, ask the person who knows, ask the person who is knowledgeable. So they took all these data given in the Holy Quran dealing with embryology and presented it to Professor Keith Moore. Professor Keith Moore is the head and chairman of the Department of Anatomy in the University of Toronto in Canada, and is one of the leading authorities in the world in the field of embryology. When Professor Keith Moore went through the translation of the various verses of the Quran dealing with embryology, he said that most of the thing which the Quran speaks about embryology is matching with the latest discoveries made in the field of embryology. But there are a couple of things which I cannot say that they are right. Neither can I say that they are wrong, because I myself not know about it. And one such verse was from Surah Iqra or Surah Alaq, chapter 96, verse number 1 and 2, which says, Iqra bismi rabbikal ladhi khalaq, khalaqal insana min alaq. Read, recite or proclaim, in the name of thy Lord who created the human beings from something which clings, a leech-like substance. So Professor Keith Moore said, I do not know whether the embryo looks like a leech or not. So he went in his laboratory and under a very powerful microscope examined the shape of the early stage of embryo and compared it with a photograph of a leech. And he was astonished at the striking resemblance. And when he was asked about 80 questions on embryology taken from the Holy Quran and Hadith, he said that if you would have asked me all these things 30 years ago, I would not be able to answer more than 50% of this. Because embryology, the development of embryology, is just recently, hardly 30 to 50 years, it's advanced. And Professor Keith Moore has written a book, The Developing Human. And in his new edition, the third edition, he has incorporated the new things which he found from the Quran and the Hadith, for which he got an award for the best medical book written in that year by any single author. And when I was doing my MBBS in the first year, we referred to this book, Developing Human by Keith Moore. If you wanted to score high marks in embryology, we referred to the book by Keith Moore. If you wanted to get just passing mark, we referred to Inderbir Singh. But if you wanted to score, we had to refer to the book by Professor Keith Moore. And later on, this book was translated into several languages of the world. Professor Keith Moore said, I have got no objection in accepting that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the messenger of God Almighty, and that the Holy Quran has to be a divine revelation. The Holy Quran says in Surah Tariq, chapter 86, verse number 5 to 7, let no man think from what he is created. He is created from a drop, emitted from a space between the backbone and the ribs. Today we have come to know the genital organs, the testes in the males and the ovaries in the female. In the embryonic age, they develop from a space where the kidney is present today, between the backbone and the 11th and 12th rib. Later on, the testes, they descend through the inguinal colon into the scrotum, and the ovaries in the female to the true pelvis. But in the embryonic age, it's in the space where the Quran speaks about, between the backbone, the spinal column, and the 11th and 12th rib. Even in the adult life, after the genital organs, they descend, yet they receive the blood supply, the nerve supply, and the lymphatic drainage from the same space, between the spinal column and the 11th and 12th rib.